But it's Barrow Ladies game against Keith and Cougars Ladies. Frisky but sunny afternoon. I'm with normal commentary. Beside me is my co-host, got some news to play. How's it going, Dan?
I'm good, Dan, thanks. I'm just praying this weather stays fair like it is now.
Everybody's out coming out to the field, so we'll quickly run through them. Harris Little, Kerry Wood, Jake Charlton, Jay Charlton, Natalie Watson, Tony Pollard, George Dowling, Emma Ewingworth, Habiba Hussain, Jasmine Bellamy, and Kelsey Keenan. What do you expect from today's game then, Graham?
Well, I've not seen that many women's ladies' games, Dan, so I've seen a couple, and what I've seen is that they are very physical. So I'm looking to see what sort of like patterns they have, patterns of play. I've been talking to the coaches, and they were both saying about bossing the middles. You know, the lingo's still the same as the men's game. You know, they've got to boss it up the middle and find some width and space on the edges, hopefully. So I'm intrigued. I'm looking forward to it.
Second game of the season for both of these teams this afternoon. First home game of the season for the Barrow Ladies. They are 1-1. So Melbourne and Halifax last week. Keithley just went down. So they're looking for their first win here of this ladies' championship campaign. As we're about to get underway now, we've got another one. Setting up for the kick-off for the ladies' team. We do have some interviews to show you as well at half time. The ladies have caught Simon Woodham. The club's stalwart, Michelle Larkin, and vice captain there. So we're underway here, starting with a short kick-off for the ladies. It's not very well taken, though, by the key fleet, number 12. The ladies are going to regain position here, and already find themselves within 20 metres of the try line, looking to get a nice early start line.
Yeah, it was a good kick-off that from Jodie. She's actually very talented football as well. She was on the books at Markham FC. I don't know if she still is now, but she took a left leg kick there, nice and short, and the ladies managed to re-keep the ball.
There's good running here now by the ladies. Nicole Sealings is going through. She finds herself 6 metres or so short of the try line. First attack here of the afternoon for the ladies. Michelle Larkin's just brought down there on the far left hand side, but the ball's been to go backwards by today's referee. Elliot Burrows is the match official this afternoon. But a good kick from this frame is taken well by the Cougars ladies. They're going to restart this first set for themselves. Just trying to get some into them. Good promising first set line going there from Mr.
Yeah, they did well there. He's a bit untidy on the end of set kick. But again, a little bit of football skills coming in there. But we'll just see what these Cougars ladies have got in the way of forward power.
So it's the Cougars now. Get some good meters at the field. Almost in the 30 metres line. Any options to the left and right? There's Kelly Wood. So, kind of force on Redford, gets a good offload away to Laura Elliott, the previous fullback. Weaving away, trying to get towards the halfway line now. Today, the referee, Elliott Burrow, indicates fifth and last tackle. Getting ready for kick towards the corner. She's just got that one fall on the ground there. I think that was really something.
Yeah, it was a good kick that day on the last tackle, Dan. It looked like it was going to clear off towards the corner. And she's just got that one fall on the ground there.
That was really something.
Yeah. Again, this is the first time back. Yeah. And by the way, Dan, we don't actually know these girls, do we? So we've never commentated on these. So apologies for any little delays in trying to catch names. first key for them. Where he's sending it back to him, back from the inside as well. It's good play there, looking for another offload. I think he's managed to get the ball away there. If he's doing the ball, he'll come backwards. It's really play on. Should have had a few more tackles eventually brought down. Just over 10 metres shy of the try line. Joe Charlton to his left, goes to the right, eventually brought down. A couple of metres in front of the sticks now as he cruises up to go to the right hand side again. A bit of a show and go there from Laura Ackroyd. There was a little short pass on there, would have been try time then. But the support player just drifted right. Get over that line, they have done it. It's a Cougars for the first blood here at the Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium. They're now 3-4. Yeah, ladies, well.
Win try time done. But the support player just drifted wide. So keep it looking to get over that line. They have done it. It's a Cougars for the first.
Kelly Wood back. Not very good, Kelly Wood.
Support player just drifted wide. So keep it looking to get over that line. They have done it.
It's a positive start, kind of thing. Keeping Cougars with us. As he does, he's got a nice kick up now on his far right hand side. I don't know, like I said, he's got his man in the ground, but I think it's better than Unsworth. Yeah, it is number 13. It's a good looking kick as well. He's got him between the sticks now, just left to the right hand side. So it's going to remain here at the Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium. Our ladies know, keep the ladies far. Yeah, it certainly looks like these girls have come to complete then. That was a good straight down, one attack, but one score. Like you say, they had just in the previous play, they had an opportunity there for a short ball, and the support runner through a hole for a 4-point there. But the score on the next tackle as it was. So the way they're going to reheat now, which gets that form that we've seen last week against Halifax, we actually annihilated the Halifax team, put another 50 points into them. And so, but we all tuned in here in a few more weeks, going in the crowds are out back next one tomorrow, I believe.
Yeah, it'll be good
to see a little bit of asset here, a little bit of atmosphere. I'm sure it spurs the players on as well. So looks like it's all really good, doesn't it? Here's the number on the back of the shirt. You're dressed as good as mine. I think she's called Spies. That's a good run, that Dan. Good strong there from the number 8, Kelly Wood. She looks a formidable player there, doesn't she? Hard to stop in full flight. I think that's a useless one because he was having that, wasn't it? So I believe that'll be now. He gets another pot forward and I guess got the 8s and 10s mixed up. And they just drop through there, Dan, there's the 6. So it's the Cougars now, they didn't want to ding ball over the top. It's going to be collected by the ladies. All ladies in the 2 it is, Abby O'Brien. She's done well again, Alan tackles there. She's found herself almost to the 30-minute tonight. She's done very well indeed there, Graham. Yeah, she did return that ball really well. That's a good passage play by Geithley, but we've just seen her spill the ball. Here comes England international Jodie Crawford now, making some good meters for the Dale ladies up towards the 40-minute mark. As it looks at edge and towards the Geithley half of the field now. A little dummy straight through the gap there for the ladies. They're making some good yards, and she just takes to the floor there. I think that was Jodie Crawford, isn't it? 19 on the 19th, I don't know, the the lady's name, Keith, the lady's father. First tragedy has been inspired by Natalie Watson. Well, these two, three cougars ladies down last week from their game, they had three of the players dispatched to hospital. Yeah. So we hope that they get a fast recovery. One had broken ribs, one had broken elbow, and one had damaged ligaments in her ankle. And not long after, a long time out of the game, they're coming back and they're on hard grounds, you know, and it's going to go for joints and things like this, as we see them now. Let's hope the call's all right long term. And of course, we're going to have to see if this is going to be a fantastic example. It's just going to be a tap by the fullback, that's unlucky, good idea. So the it's going to be a 25, that's all fast, it's going to be a 20 metre restart for Keith now. But Laura Elliott's going to tap this ball, she's going to give it to Laura Ackroyd. She's well covered there by two worthy defenders. The ball comes to his left hand side. It's coming right through underneath us there. Shapes a pass. Coming off. Jodie Salton out to Ackroyd again, back inside. So it's Nat, is it Natalie? I'd be the wrong way around. Natalie Watson, we do believe that is. Another good run from her. So it's the key to that, so that's the halfway line. The number 13 is only Ainsworth. Yourself on the other side of the field, now it's going to the left and now going down the right to the wing, he gets from the good defence off on the ball, ladies and gentlemen. Scoreline's still remains, ladies nil, always makes a touch there, and I've just done just that, good defence by Jordy Hoffman, and we'll walk back up. We start the game with a tap. Of course, COVID rules now don't allow for scrums. We'll sort of start wearing a mask maybe when we're after tomorrow. So it's going to be the Raiders to restart here. To get their first points of the afternoon on the board here. Coming to his right hand side. Pretty close to the left, where the ball gets to the left, and the ladies find themselves right in the middle of the field, but up towards the halfway line, going down this left hand side once more. Good stop there, but a good fierce tackle. The ladies want to be brought down. It's kind of ladies now going down this left hand side. Kind of good offload out of the ball still. Well, the referee's moving just a lot. Yeah, I don't know what's going on, but these are the official team sheets. Jodie Clark from now towards the comments on that for the ladies, ladies. Swing this ball back up to Oz's right hand side again. And back into Oz's inside now, just dropped down by the power there. Just trying to show yourself out of that tackle to get a quick play of all the ladies and ladies. Coming down the left once more. I believe that's Molly Lennon. Edging even closer for the Raiders ladies. Yeah, little dinner to try to find some ladies for yourself. Held up there. The same video that manages to get the ball out to the right hand side. Big tackle comes in. It's going to be a knock on from the ladies. It's going to remain here at the Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium. No ladies, no. Keep the ladies there.
Yeah, they just need to find a little bit of cohesion a bit, the Raiders ladies at the moment, and just be a little bit more consistent. They're not quite getting to the end of set properly and turning it over. I mean, I'm sure on another day she would have took that ball and scored a try, but it was not to be, because it was a great man and ball tackle, women and ball tackle, sorry. It's Natalie Watson's really having a heavy impact on the game at the moment, but I'm really impressed. How's it not gone?
It's a knock on there, so the ball's going to go back to our ladies. And this 30 metre man got an advantage here to try and get that first try for himself, up for me on the score.
It's just a little bit untidy, isn't it, man? It's just both teams are turning possession over.
So, in the shot now, it's going to play this ball for the ladies. There's a new pass here, he's got plenty of options, but it's a Kelly Friend. He's managed to find us on the 20 metre line now. He's back up to the using the forwards again, but he's in here with the ladies. That's Jodie Marley, I believe.
Jodie Marley, yeah, right, he's done.
Rear catcher than we have. We'll get better at these ones if we have two, so it's not all over the place, I promise you. The ladies now find themselves 10 metres out. Still looking for that first try of the afternoon. The Jodie with the race ball. Left hand side with a great ball. And the ladies of Edge Street is going to be the first try of the afternoon for Barrow Ladies. Making the scoreline here. Barrow Ladies 4. Keeping Ladies 4.
Themselves 10 metres out. Still looking for that first try of the afternoon. The Jodie with the race ball. Left hand side with a great ball. And the ladies of Edge Street is going to be the first.
Saunders it is then for the ladies. Tying the scoreline here in Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium. Scoreline now by the ladies' four. Keep it ladies' four.
Yeah, it's a lot of work try that, Dan. We worked it to that left hand side and really found the space well and completed more clinically. I've got a little wager that says you'll tip this over, Dan.
How much? And the defensive group.
What do we think? She's left footed, so she's naturally going to put it across the face of the goals.
So she's going to go inside.
Have a very young.
If fancy something, yes, she's using a few steps. That one step to the side, she's taking the time of this one. Which was used for many years. Has got the distance on it though. It's just swept left of the sticks of the leaves that's going to remain here at the Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium. And the ladies' four, Keith's ladies' four.
Very interesting, Dan, because she's been kicking the ball off with her left foot and she's just took that conversion with the right. So I don't know if ambidextrous is the same for your feet as it is for your hands, but
I don't know how much you can definitely use both feet.
Yeah. Not so good effects on that occasion, Dan.
So they've just had a little bit of a behind the sticks. Looking to get themselves back into this game. I think they're their own worst enemy, haven't they? Because all the pressure's coming from their own hands, Gordon.
Yeah, well, it's the same as the Raiders. Well, the Raiders have given a lot of possession, well, some possession, really. But, you know, it's about keeping hold of the ball and then punishing like the Raiders just did,
place there in a try when you get gifted possession. This last Mary is going to be kicking it off, and then Laura Ackroyd, she has a heavy say on what this team do. It's stand off. She had a few good plays and a few good runs. Let's see how it goes through the game, how she develops. So it's a kick here by Laura Ackroyd to get us underway once again. So that's right. From Matt Saunders with the ball. It's just bounced over the leg of Sam Laura, and it's going to be a 20-meter restart here for the Cougars, and once again. We're going to be attacking that line in the back of the river and far side. That's all we're saying, Dan. You know, it's these this field position for the Keyford Cougars now. They're going to be centre field. They can split, they can work one way, they can really do what they like. And they've got it for free. Let me show that. So it's Sarah Shalotti. He's going to be playing this ball. And he'll be passing that right. That was just a mad. I was a solitary. I don't see it too much if you don't want to go and notice what happened to him. So it's a key that's now bringing the ball back into that. Centre of the field. Find themselves just 12 metres away from the try line. Looking to take a lead once more here at my Johnson Prestige Stadium. So Dummies there, so still managing to get through that defence, manages to get an off-roll work. A couple of metres shy of the try line now, looking for their second try of the afternoon. As the Cougars up to go towards his left-hand side again. Just can't break through that ladies' defence though. And it's going to be George Ryan, who's taken down extremely well. Pushing them back a few more metres. Once again going down the blind side of the Cougars. Number 8, Kenny, it's Natalie Watson. She's going to have the try line again, I think she's going to take a look at it. That's found up, good defence there from the Barrows. Yeah, they did very well there, Dan. You know, they were under the pump there for four of them, set of six, and they managed to keep them out. And again, that's Natalie, the prop, she's, it really is a powerhouse. He's going to have a really good one, trying to stop that one. He was just trying to stop his foot, and he's gone straight into the arms of it. Keith and Taylor, and they've got another set of six here. Just 10 metres to go. That's the fullback now, Warren Elliott. She's having a go on her own, brought down well. Maybe by the ladies' defence, and he keeps strong here. But it's Keith who wants more side towards that try line. Defence did so well for the by the ladies last week against Hammett, that's putting in just the one try. But Auburn this afternoon has just conceded a second. Keithley Cougars are in once more this afternoon, extending their lead here at the Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium, making the scoreline now. Our ladies 4, Keithley Cougars 8.
Defensive did so well for the Barrow ladies last week against Halifax, conceding just the one try. But Auburn this afternoon has just conceded a second.
Really dominating this game for the Keithley Cougars. So second try of the afternoon then for the Keithley Cougars this afternoon. First from Pennywood, second from Laura Ackroyd. Keeps it from running from the sticks, looking to extend it here to 10 points any moment now. Amy Ainsworth again, with the kicking duties. Straight in between the post and the scoreline here at Matt Johnson Prestige Stadium as it stands. It's by Ladies 4, Keithley Cougars 7. Yeah, I think the Raiders just need to control the ball a little bit better, cut out some of the enforced errors, maybe get a couple of bodies.
Defence did so well for the Barrow Ladies last week against Halifax, conceding just the one try. But Auburn this afternoon has just conceded a second.
So between the Ladies' defence getting out of the meter sticks, easy as you like. It's really something that the Barrow Ladies coaching staff on the team has really something they've got to work on midweek. Just after only conceding one try next week against Halifax, I think like you say, Ackroyd, she's been a standout player so far for Keithley. and we really need to sort of need to get up and cut down our options, cut down our thinking time, because she's just a bit, she stood off a little bit and she carved through them for the 4-pointer. So we're going to leave now, it comes to ball down, and eventually picks it, picks up. There we go, pick number 5, Ella Town to Keithley. Stopped by a strong tackle by Sam Norman. And we're on 30-meter line, it's Norman again, it's chasing that. Attack loss is going through it again, it's good work there. And the ball there is eventually. Some more support comes in, and they are brought down, still on that 30-meter line, a couple of seconds at this. First set after the kickoff. Let's try and score there. Laura Ackroyd, trying to make some more meters for Keithley ladies. Any other options to go now as they look at Drew Charlton. Some of them legs herself, trying to get the Keithley up towards the halfway line now. Down to that point, but there we go, a little knock on there, spotted by the referee. And I must admit, the Raiders, ladies look pretty relieved at that van. And a good set of six here, you know, just spend a bit of time and try and, you know, work the game and manage the game, as they call it, for a little bit. Get to the end sets, turn the ball over in good areas for them. So it's Jordan Edmund, the captain for the ladies, is going to restart this one now. Belton's all towards the right hand side with Amy Sharp, the ball of ladies. She's on the 30 meter line now. Just trying to get to play this ball as quick as she can. As we cut here, put it out to the left. And the ladies using them strong forward, and they have to bring the ball back in towards the centre field. 20 meters out now. Looking to bring this game back on 11 turns. Going down this left hand side where they found that try earlier on. So the ladies over there screaming at today's referee looking for a good comment for the hands half away around here today's referee on the road. Yeah, there is a little bit, just a little bit around the shoulder and off up around the chin, I think a little bit there. Best way to describe that one, Danny. So it's going to be a fresh set from the referee, ladies and ladies. They find themselves less than 10 minutes to go and it's a great little hour. The ball has just come loose as she was edging for the try line there. It's Fern Henderson looking for the first try for the club. He's a little bit of a excitement going.
Yeah, he's just like some enthusiasm. You've just got to keep a bit of composure and try and look after the ball and just not turn it over. Again, I'm sure the Raiders, he could have been on for points there. It's Keithley defence though, Dan. I must say, it is quite rigid and then well organised. They don't seem to be rushing out the line or anything like that. They're jumping and missing tackles easy.
Face of Keithley's now. They still hold this 10 points to 4 advantage. Over the battle, ladies, put the ball towards the halfway line. Robbie O'Brien takes the ball well. Keeps the ball inside the Keithley half in the field. As we experience, we're still laughing at this now. This is a butcher's dog suit,
yeah. He's certainly got a lot of experience at the back of his team.
He's took a bit of a headshot, then. It's an indicator to the referee. But like the football, he's in one place, he's just going to know it.
Yeah,
good to see.
And Jordy's looking eager to get on with this, and you know, they really need to just take the time and plan what they're going to do, make sure they get to the end of this set and not turn it over after 3 or 4 tackles.
And that's a concept in front of the people as well, although he's going to make a great effort out of the world, and that's how it goes. Sarah Swarthy from the previous team. I'm guessing she's the captain. Both captains are there, though.
So by the way, they're going to go restart now. The left hand side of the field, and the 10 meter now. But first set here to find themselves level back in this game. Looking to make it 2-2 this afternoon as their Super League aspirations continue with the balls coming loose. The safety man was cheeky offloading the process and crucially regained possession once again. Another handling from the ladies.
I think it was just a little bit telegraphed the pass that she was going to play there. I think me and you could have caught that one. Oh, that's really clear. So it's time to start off when you're on the right quad. Looking some good numbers again. Five key for ladies. I will find herself on the front to meet tonight, and that is. But Shamaya Hussein. Trying to get herself up towards the halfway line. Keith with ladies. Stiff a nice tackle now. Let's see if this can put this kick. It's going to go and slice off the side of the foot now from Colin Cross. It's taken away by the ladies. Oh, ladies. Still find themselves in their own half of the field now, though. Score line remains here. Colin Johnson goes through the stadium. Arrow 4, Keith with 10. Michelle Lightfoot is. It gets the goal inside the Keith with half of the field. Looking once again from Ballard Ladies. Going down this left edge. Liverland, who's looking to kick for a ball over the top, motionless, managed to just get offload away. And the referee deems it a tackle first. So we're playing the ball here on the centimetre back. Wade's getting desperate to get another try on the ball before half time. As Ben Henderson, who's so close to it, trying to self earlier on, makes a line towards the 10 metre referee with his whistle. I'm just trying to see what his signal was. He's like a shoulder charge in the tackle. Shoulder charge, yeah. He went like that, but I didn't quite see what he did. He gave him his hand. So the Raiders got a repeat set here, and some of them Keith's defenders were looking tired when they were trying to get back in that previous set then. So I think if we show a little bit of composure here now, I'm sure they can score. And we won't be far off half time now, I would imagine. That's the as it is, and then they're trying to score. Paul Bailey's edging well at the south walls at the try line. And himself is into his shot line. Everyone being hit by it. He's going to have a go at himself. The ball's going to lose once again. Nice move comes to the end. It's going to put that ball up. Well, the ladies continue this attack coming down the right hand side, going towards the centre of the field. And is it Jordan Marley? Yes, he's coming over there. She gets back up. Good strong defence here, though, from Keith Ladies. Stopping Bono from getting over that try line. They're going to beat the ball to the other side. Michelle Lightfoot now got that one. She's found some new one around. And it's going to be in front of a try. Sam Norman, it is this time for the Ladies. He's going to head towards six just for good measure. Levelling the score. Home now with a kick to come, hopefully, anyway. As he stands at the minute, Barrow Ladies 8. Keith Ladies 10. Great individual try there, though.
She did well there, Dan, to get round the back and make the kick an easier one under the sticks. Again, the Raiders just showed a little bit more composure there.
And now that try lines, everyone brings the ball out to the right hand side. Michelle Larkin now got that one. She's found some room on her right. And it's going to be in front of a try. Sam Norman, it is this time for the Ladies. He's going to head towards sticks just for good measure.
Levels the defence, but leaves it vulnerable in a contact. So I think if she just dropped her shoulder, took him on a little bit more, they'd create that doubt, and she might even nip him for a try or two, because she's only been through the 7 years off the line herself.
So it's level now, lining this conversion attempt up. Just the level of scores here, the Mad Johnson Best Food Stadium. That's currently down the road is 8, Keith the road is 10. Someone of Jordan's Carter. As the game just starts, and the scores are tied now with the Matt Johnson Prestige. Barrow 10, Keithley 10. All to play for as we approach half time, Graham.
Yeah, it's a tight game. I'd like to say it's going to
take a try lines. Everyone brings the ball out to the right hand side. Michelle Larkin now got that one. She's found some room on the right. And it's going to be in front of a try. Sam Norman, it is this time for the Ladies. He's going to head towards sticks just for good measure.
You know, Jordan Rutherland, you know, I mean, as I was saying before, she used to play football for, I don't know if she still does, Markham FC Ladies. Yeah. But when she first started kicking goal, you know, she had a real problem trying to get the ball over the back.
just want to go see some sort of mid time show. Can't be left to do that again. Bad joke, can you?
No.
It brightens the evening.
That's bad afternoon.
I just think someone's checking out my key with the door.
I did last week.
I'm not going anywhere at all, Dan. I'm not allowed. I'm grounded.
So, only 10 minutes left here. Is it okay? Friend of ours, it was just in a head down to kick him straight to her. Look at her smiling. I never see a picture of both of them, she's not smiling. Oh, she's done well there. Good reactions. It's going to be a lot worse.
Yeah, that's quite amazing then, sort of like this room there, which is just my headset. And then, oh, by the way, pick that ball up, it's just running past me.
Just got a bit of a pull from play, don't you? And that's how it is, it's just on the floor. Being treated by the PT physio, just moving for a position.
Julie's ready to get in there. You play for each other and you play with a smile on the face, they're laughing and joking each other down there now while they're breaking play, you know, it's good to see. Helps with the sunshine out as well.
So it's the ladies now.
Could potentially be the final attack.
Top this first time for him. Johnson Prestige Stadiums,
that's the goal by far, we're past that too.
Yeah, we've got away with that one there.
Looking for a view around here.
Is George trying to find some wins to move on around from that left hand side? The road is set. Break through here. As the second eventually finds the hands of Michelle Larkin, he's going to charge towards that line, using all the power. The strength he's got in them upper legs. Find yourself just 5 or 6 metres short of the try line now. It's good for Max Sackle. Let's see what the ladies can do with this one. Liverpool's trying to get that ball free. So this is starting to create some room for themselves towards this try line. But once again, strong defence from the key for Cubis ladies team there. Keeping out with Amy Sharp. For a potential game changer. Right on the verge of half time. Again, the score's going to be 10 points apiece here.
A better passage of play there from the Raiders. They're starting to control the ball now and not turning it over cheaply. And the end result is these two Vikings have won 90 metres, which is, you know, 5 minutes before half time, hard to do.
This is 5 minutes left in the clock here, and that's obviously the best thing. Score on here. Our ladies 10, Keith, the ladies 10. A very competitive first half action. Three girls in the tackle once again. Stephen Keithley from breaking inside the Raiders tackle. A few of us are fantastic tackle wire. From the ladies, number 4, Sam Norman, trying to score earlier on. Keeping down the big prop. Matthew Watson. Trying to score himself earlier on in the game. Keithley now to shoot this ball out towards the right hand side, finding themselves. Keeping inside the Raiders tackle. A few of us are trying to push defence from the ladies. Back out of these tackles, didn't you?
I'll tell you what, they're strong. They're strong. I underestimated how strong the defence would be. You just certainly don't back out of anything, does it?
Fans are sure Larkin actually brings one tackle. Maybe not all those 20 metres. Fans are sure eventually stopped. Just in front of the road, 30 metres. Not a good one in there.
Final floor.
Oh, there it goes now.
That's not only there.
Back on a ponytail there. Two of the referees. Got to do something with that one, you can close yourself over in the final of the ground, we're happy with that light.
And so, the ladies now still forcing the way through. That's it. It's good play that there, Dan. She noticed that the Keithley player was slow getting back, had a back turn, was offside, so she could run after knowing that she couldn't tackle her.
That's a good ball out to this wall, just right hand side. She's trying to find an offload before she gets thrown in the touch. It's eventually stopped.
A foot stick to touch line there.
I think that's a great goal looking down on the field. I don't think there's any linesman.
I think it's just one official in the middle. Yeah, it was a shame there. It's a try opportunity. So I went begging there, really. I'm not sure about the rules, Dan. I'm not sure if you're out to actually, like, pull hair. You know, but she used to be pulled about by a ponytail, I didn't she? It's definitely a problem you have had to deal with, Dan.
Well, yeah, not in the last few years, Dan.
I said I'm up here to.
Well, let's see, he's the ladies now. Find himself just down 20 metres and have a score of nearly 10 points apiece here at Matt Johnson Prestwood Stadium. A couple of minutes to go before we go to half time. I smell a bit of silence, I'm distracted. Hopefully, I'll come in up here and this can keep the odds. If you're here for 20 minutes, the answer is yes. It's Keith Hill, it's the number 3, so we'll be seeing. Back towards the middle of the field. Good strong defence down the ball from Moise. And it's collected by the ladies doing the knock on by the referee Elliot Burrows.
Yeah, Laura Ackroyd there, down to just forcing it a little bit, trying to release that ball. Good idea, but just keep the game away. And I was just about to say that neither side want to concede any points this close to half time. The Raiders have got a real chance here now to just nick another score and go in with a better advantage.
And you could just sort of need to go this first half. If the Raiders are going to get on the start, they need to do it quickly. As Cody Crawford. That's that ball reaching the ladies. Maybe the baby will win a thousand. Down this right hand side and back towards the middle again.
Trying to create this deadlock down right on half time, it'd be good. We've got a 10-point deadlock. 10 all at the moment.
Can we find it? He's been a steep of hers. A couple of metres shy of the try line now as the seconds remaining in this first half. Let's see what they can do with this one. It's going to be a kick over the top and he's going to run it in with a forward pack and then the hands of Jordan Hunderland.
He goes in on the road, so goes round between the sticks. Second before half time. The ladies are going to go in with a lead now. It's by the ladies 14, plus the ladies 10.
Again, she just showed and go there, Dan. She dropped her shoulder and just went for it herself and come up with a 4-pointer under the sticks. And I'm sure she'll convert her own try.
So first round against the new entry, you better lay this one from the start line.
You can deal with this one. You're going to be a kick over the top and you're going to run it in with a forward pack and then the hands of Jordan Hunderland. He goes in on the road, so goes round between the sticks. Second before.
You get out of that from Luther. Yeah, that's a big professional.
The professionals, Bobby and I.
Not that old thing. Simple conversion attempt for Jordy. Right in between the sticks. I expect her to kick this one more, didn't
I? She's trying to kick this right footed, but be honest.
Yeah, I know.
She must have the luxury from the right hand side to keep the right foot or the left foot and the opposite to the other foot as it naturally curves that way.
Conversion attempt is good from Jordan Hunderland up in the scoreline now. The Matt Johnson Prestige. Our ladies 16, keep the ladies 10. And now goes to half time. Who's that? I think. Yep, so it's half time with the Matt Johnson Prestige then. 3 tries to pick our ladies. Who from next round is Sam Norman and Jordan Hunderland then before the half time. And so 2 tries for Keith McKeever's ladies. Laura Ackroyd and Leslie Watson. Scoreline 16-10. I'd want to summarise it and go for the first down.
Well, it's the first 20 was a bit of a nip and tuck due to unforced errors. The second 20, I think the Raiders just controlled the ball a little bit more and had a bit better field position. And like you say, Jordan Silver and I just taking the initiative and getting their own try, just starting to control the game a little bit. And the Raiders probably will look to build on that the second half.
So, I mean, we're back with the second half action here. And for now, I've got to go find a brew and a bacon sign. That's not outside 15 minutes.
come back for the second half action there. The Matt Johnson plus Steve Steele in between Barrow Ladies and Casey Ladies. And this ladies is Jody Crawford making some fantastic yards there for the ladies team. Almost up towards the 40 meter mark in the first run of the set. Referee Bruce Whistler once more. It's the Cougars ladies that have been cut offside, so straight away, Barrow Ladies are going to find themselves. That's the halfway line. Couldn't even stand by 16 points to 10.
Yeah, what they need to do this second half, Dan, is start a good tempo and complete a couple of early sets and try and get the initiative and build on that as the second half goes through. You said the key three coaches there, they're on their team. You want them to cut out silly mistakes and try and build a bit of pressure and likewise, like Barrow, get control of the game.
Oh, the ball's just gone backwards there from that. And that's a tenth.
And he's still going through. There's a great bit burst by Jordan Morley. Oh, and the ball's just come loose against him. He's trying to find it. Now the back offload is going to do the knock on by the match referee. And the Burrows. That's unlucky and frustrating.
I think he might have a penalty there, Dan.
Maybe he's doing it. He's been released out the ball.
Just going to get a restart for the ladies. Comes up towards his left hand side. Good running here. And that's going to be Crawford. He's just trying to edge away over the wires. He's been held up there. And strong key through defence once again. He's scored on the main. So yeah, Barrow 16, key through 10.
There's been an injury there, obviously.
Very, very gingerly getting back up to the feet. Jody Crawford, it was really a attempt to England international goal there.
That's right, yeah.
That's international players in the ranks. There's Jody Crawford. That's that ball towards the left hand side. The try score in that Saunders from the first half. Can't get a second one of the afternoon, which has stopped a few metres shy. Ball come back towards the middle of the field now. It's Jordy again, it's going to have another attempt here, and the referee's happy that time, he's going to go over. It's going to be another try for Barrow Ladies now, this time from Jordy Crawford, making the scoreline of Barrow 20, Kingston 10.
The second one of the afternoon, but she stops a few metres shy.
Crawford, it was then. Trying to score there for fourth time for the afternoon. Played by the ladies. Extending the score line to Barrow 20, Keith and 10. Who can really attempt to come?
I'm going to finish that sentence. Was the female online? Is it a four pointer?
Otherwise, it sounds just a bit, I don't know, awkward.
What about internationals, Dan? Whether in the ranks of the ladies, Barrow ladies, whether.
I
can sit home and get to look shit up like that, you know. I don't have to stay here and do it.
I was down to the start talking to you because it's kind of straight to my own players.
There's
a lot of capacity to get a jump while you get out of there, you
know.
Another successful conversion attempt third of the afternoon for Jody. Riverland making the score line now. Ballerina's 22. Keep it 10.
You were just saying about international. I'm not competing with that. Right, anybody else want to say anything?
I was trying to say something.
What about internationals? In the ranks of the ladies, we've got a double union in the international. In Hannah Sherlock. My little notes tell me here. And also, previous players, well, actually, Roger Rodgers, but we're not playing today. Emily Stazerkay, she's on the books at Wigan. Beth Lindsay, she's on at Wakefield. And Georgie Miller is at York. Like I said, they're two players, two best players that have advanced and been on the play in the Women's Super League.
Very good.
Well, we've seen great and what we spoke to the staff and the players over the past few years. I do genuinely believe we can generally make Women's Super League, if not over this season, possibly. Possibly in this season, if not, I'm not sure in the next.
Speaking
to the coaches. That's what the game plan is, definitely. Remember, I watched it in a couple of games that I've watched it for the Davies stand up. Emily Stosic just sticks in the man. What an aggressive and fierce tackle she is. But even though they've lost the player of Harry's presence, stature, and that playing for Wigan, they continue to build this team and continue to carry on winning, picking up big points. Looking to make it 2-2 this afternoon. And we're holding a 12-point advantage over the Cougars ladies team. 22 points to 10 here it is at the Johnson Prestige. A bit of confusion there. They awarded a knock-on, which means you have to turn the ball over. So the Cougars now have possession just shy of the halfway line. So it's Kelly Wood for the Cougars ladies. Actually stopped in the halfway line, should not be about something. There's the ball, they'll go down the blind side. It's strong defence from the ball ladies. Just a few inches short of going out into touch there. Just to get the ball up. They're going to bring the ball back into the wall. There's another stands here from the Cougars ladies. They've done very well there, but still only going sideways. They're looking for some space in the ladies' defence. They've found a little bit of a gap on that left hand edge, but again. Good strong defence from the Bally ladies, bringing them down on the 30 metre mark. Another step of team play here, boys. Yeah, both sides here, down and outside, taking to each other. You know, they're getting met fiercely on both sides. On both sides, they've got the ball. It's Sam Long and his earlier star story for the ladies. He's going to get back up to her feet here. Which is a bit wounded. I don't know, she's got a hand behind the head, trying to get her back. If I'm not too sure, I'm sure Sam Norman is the daughter of Colin Norman, who's with the Dalton ARLFC. Locally. Yeah, I'm sure that's why. I'm just guessing, it's that time. I'm saying I'm guessing. I might have made a cheeky phone call. So it's Keith Lee on the attack again, good strong, and then eventually get the hand by Kelly Friend. And themselves 20 metres away, just under 20 metres in fact. So Maya Hussain using all the power there to take Keithley. And then 5 minutes in the sticks, but it's just a nice tackle now. They've got plenty of options on the left hand right. They've got to go towards this right hand side. And they're going to pass this one out. They're running back into towards the middle now. So he's trying to have another offload there. It's bounced off Jody Lidlund. And I think Jody is going to battle picking that one up. But it's going to begin the knock on here. Back to the official Ellie Burrows. It's not going to be a knock on.
So, it's just that Jordan knocked it on and trying to recover the ball. So, he's been in a dangerous position now. And we've got another set of six. And this number six, Laura Floyd, trying to make her way through there. She's very dangerous near that line. I'm very impressed with her.
One of the busiest players of 16, to be honest, without a doubt.
He's
looking to get himself back into this game. Only 12 points behind the Stones, 22 points to 10. We've seen the Vince Hudson for the line again, and the ball's been taken away from her by who's Jody Crawford, I believe.
She's pretty fast for the
captain. Yes,
I was just looking there. This is going to open up.
So already the ladies up to Laws and he's over the halfway of the ball. The son Larkin is not too impressive with this, he's brought down there, but she gets on with it nonetheless. This time it's Vicky that's brought down. Vicky Leeper, I believe, pronounced that right. It's one of the second player, but it's Michelle Larkin it is this time. Telling the referee that she's dropped down by the neck of her shirt. Targets are the size this year, she's number 22. I'm sure she'll have some target size. So I'm back up to her feet now, so the ladies are going to restart this one. We're still in the field. It's strong winning again from the ladies. time, so it's 30 metres away now. Let's extend in their lead here in this Women's Championship match for Matt Johnson Prestige for his first home game of the season. He's destroying Halifax last weekend. Again, he's a good place in the Raiders. 20 metres shy now, he's stuck from last tackle. Let's see what they do with this one. Let's see, the Raiders are going to try to kick over the top. Kelly does eventually get to the hands of Joe Hudlin. Sporting over in that corner. We've got a lot of space there. He's bounced very, very well into Amy Sunderland. She's going to go in herself. It's a fantastic try from the Raiders. Keithy left himself wide open in that left-hand corner. And the Raiders bounced on it. The scoreline now. All Ladies 26, Keithy 10. She did very well there, Damien Sunderland, as the ball bounced straight into the chest off that kick from Jodie Wakeland. Great step as well.
Yeah, you know, she obviously weighed up that the Keithley defence was scrambling across, thinking she's going to go for the corner flag. She turned the body, she took the ball, and immediately ended off that left foot in under the sticks. I'm not quite under the sticks, but I'm sure it's quite enough for Jodie to put the conversion over.
This should be another simple conversion attempt for Jodie Wakeland. And let's extend this scoreline by another 2 points now as the Raiders get to win the lead of this one. This is another line between the Raiders' sticks. The Raiders now 28, Keith the Raiders 10.
Just noticing behind the.
Well, I don't think you can hear much of that.
I just noticed there behind the sticks that ball was caught by Steve Ray, the Raiders' assistant coach. Took that very well. I'm sure at one time and a few years ago, he'd have took it and returned it a few hundred yards.
I think the body language on these two players now, if the Raiders can just keep playing as they are, they're completing sets quite well now and starting to dominate this game. I think the game's won, it's just whether the Raiders let them in and keep them get their heads up again and have another good 10 minutes, or whether they can just see this game out and control it, use a good kick, chase it down, and force the errors down at the key end of the field. So, looks like another dominant performance from the Raiders. They've definitely started off the second half, they've only started the first half. Two tries. So, about 5 tries this afternoon for 5 separate scorers. This is a female reaching to get in the score sheet as well. As he can hold his 28 points to 10 lead, as Michelle just slips there, she tries to step round. Let's hope it was just a slip and not an ankle injury. That's what it's going to be fine. Craig Goldnatt, head down, bursting one by the down quick, and the Tigers are all in his back.
She's feisty. Laura Ackroyd there, starting to show a little bit of frustration, Dan. Don't think she's going to help the team, really. She's probably one of the key players, and probably one of the last things that can afford, is for her to do a 10-minute in the Sunday.
Given his ball is not being kicked into touch during these new COVID restrictions. So it's a Ladies now, back with themselves less than 20 metres. Shadows are shining, looking to get past that 30-point mark here, and enjoy some test stage. This is going on all in now. Is there a leap into it? Kelly Zender is now looking at Amy on the score sheet. She's wrapped down just before the try line. He's in a high shot there. for the Raiders again. This is good. This is good for the Raiders, not good for Keithley, because it's a bit of a repeat set and the start is showing stress. So it'd be hard to keep these Raiders out again. I would be quietly confident that they will be getting another try here then. Jodie Crawford, here she goes into that line. But just managed to hold her up, I think. Here, Patty there now with dummy arms. She's got shape, left and right. I think she's going to go to the left with Claire Galbert. She takes the ball. Again, tries to go over. That ball's reefed out onto her. Yeah, it's another set. Another set of 6 here from the back of the ladies. Looking to extend it even further. Still winning by 28 points to 10 here. Just over 20 minutes left to play. This match should be the Women's Championship. And then reset. Raiders can just take the time, get some air in, think about what they're going to do, not rush it, and complete a full set of 6 if they need to. This one is not going down this right hand side. Not at all. So the ball's just come loose there. It's edging closer and closer. I can't believe it's just a little bit of excitement, but. It's a lack of composure really there, but like you say, you can't be blamed. They're going moving that ball left to right there, and it's just took her eyes off the ball momentarily. But they're the little things that really crucify teams, and that when they're struggling to defend, when they're tired, when they're frustrated, you know, another 6 pointer or a 4 pointer goes in. There's Keith Ladies now on the attack. It's trying to finish this time from the Bar Ladies. Keeping them back on the line, 10 metres now. Getting the ball back in towards the middle. They're passing the blind side, putting them in there. Right off towards the fast hands here. Good play by the Keithley Ladies. Let's see what it can do as it goes. The power of the defence try and line themselves up. Stop them from making any more metres at the field. Good defence indeed it was. From Amy Sunderland and Jodie Litherland. Trying to find another offload now as they fall back Laura Elliott. Oh, he's taking the time of this one. She can't play the ball. Hopefully, she'll just continue. Keithley still stuck inside her own half of the field. Again, good strong defence from the Raiders number 20, Claire Galvez. The ball's been loose in that second row. Will play on. He's gone down, he's picked the ball up. So it's the Raiders now. They find themselves 35 metres away from the sticks. And the Keithley, Raiders getting very, very feisty. The incident down here on the pitch, and referee needs to get a hold of this one. So the other one's not happy about something there. I think it's a player down there who's been targeted there by the Keithley defence. So the friend comes in. I think Laura Ackroyd, this number 6, she's been sailing across the roof for the last 10 minutes now, Dan. And I think she's done something there, I'm not aware of what actually happened, but a lot of the players very animated there. Running straight with the referee, and that action needs taken. Keith, unfortunately, is it as well as the players are losing their heads a bit. I think Jodie's trying to indicate that there's a knee put on the face and a tackle, and that's what she's not happy about. Just ask me to go out on camera. I'm sure we'll have some work. It's great, it's all for me. It's not that. That's Saxon Liverland. All right. I think everybody can understand that rule. That was just funny. Language we heard over the French. If you could hear it. So that's the way he's now doing this quite like. So there's another. Number 10, Kelly Wood. As Jodie Crawford is once again using the powerful legs that she's got in the house to get to the floor down before she's tackled. Good step last step. And with the second, Raiders find themselves 10 metres shy of the try line now, looking to extend on this 20 points 10 lead that they already hold here at Johnson Prestige. Good enough, and it is going towards the left hand corner.
has found Michelle Larkin. And Michelle Larkin's in for the sixth try of the afternoon for Barrow Ladies, extending the scoreline to Barrow 3.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great response there from the Raiders. They kept their heads, they did exactly what the captain asked for. They just took the ball, played the game how it should be, and the best way to react to any accusations that players have been using foul play against you is to have them stubborn money for own sticks, which is where they've gone. So I'm sure they're happy. They're happy there. I don't know if George Jordan's ever happened to them, really, to be honest. She's a very strong character. I'm sure she won't be mad in the same.
And certainly have to play out by Johnson Christie, the scoreline battle. Ladies 32, Keithley Ladies 10. As the Arrow gets written away with this one now. Six separate trial scores this afternoon as well, don't they?
Yeah, it's a good distribution. It means they're playing good rugby and moving the ball around.
I put you on mortgage on this thing. Put yours on it, not a bit of ice for me, really. Straight for the middle once again from Jordan Everland, extending the scoreline now. Barrow Ladies 34, Keithley 10.
So we've got 20 minutes, 19 minutes to go then. Are we going to see a procession of points, do you think?
I think we'll get this one out of the way in a minute. We've got 53 points. How many fans is left in Stockton doing it again here? I think we're going to have a piece of really see us the heads a little bit. But the coaching staff are just talking about that one behind the sticks of the team, trying to make it cool down. I think it's a penalty coming in. What's these penalties? Hit the heads a little bit.
Yeah.
I feel like hard work they put in the first half as well. Taking the same.
The thing is, it doesn't matter if it's the men's game or the women's game, players have got to keep control of their emotions, because especially if you're a pivot and you act an iceberg, generally you run the team. So if you lose your head, the team loses its direction. And unfortunately at the moment, it looked like the Keithley Cougars have lost that a little bit. And hopefully the Raiders will be hoping they can take advantage of that to run in some more points.
The momentum is definitely inside of the Ladies at the minute though. Just once again, they find themselves making good meters, quick meters up the field. And there's that good time run again from Claire Gildart. She looks desperate to get on there. She's trying to reach to be here. And lucky. It just knocks down more. She's hit the ground in the second half. Very effective there, because she made some good meters.
She hit the hole well, didn't she? Jordan just held the ball for her, showed her where to go. She went right through.
It's basically going to be a restart at the 20-meter mark now.
I think it's fair to say the Raiders have charged up for this last 20. They're not just letting the game fizzle out.
First piece of the man just left hand side. And they've got their first shot of the afternoon. The Raiders team have cut them up. So far in the second half. Can lose on straight again into the hand. The Barrow Ladies are going to get another massive advantage here. Find themselves just 30 meters away. You can see try number 7 in the afternoon. That's a good step and a good down run there. Another 10 meters gained from the Barrow Ladies. There's a lady now towards that 10 meter mark. He's been with a few more fresh legs as well to get himself in this game. Okay, Smith, it was that time.
a few interchanges, the ball comes back up to Jeremy Evelyn. He's still going, he's cuts back onto the inside now. This is Matt Sarnold, the first scorer from earlier on, looking for a second of the afternoon. 15 minutes left to go here by Johnson Preston. The ball's coming loose, it's going to be Michelle Larkin. He tries to scramble and put that one up, though. But it's a couple of metres lost there for the ladies. The point is once more. That's in charge of Cinder finds a good pass off to her right. It's Kerry Smith. Brings it back in towards the centre. Looking to head to what, back towards the stakes. It's different last tackle now. They've got the numbers over on this right hand side. They have just found it going to be into the corner. It's going to be another try in the afternoon. I think this try is Abby O'Brien. Seven tries, seven seconds left. Try score is great.
Yeah, and you'll notice, Dan, we're on the opposite sides of the field. We've got right wingers scoring, left wingers scoring, centres scoring, second rowers scoring. So they have played the game with a little bit of width.
The coaching staff would be really happy after that first half hour where the key for Kiwis were looking quite strong actually and maybe looking like it's going to be a hard draft afternoon because maybe making mistakes, but they seem to have regathered themselves and slowly, the longer the game's gone on, the more the Raiders have controlled this game. A bit like hopefully the senior team are going to be this afternoon.
Yeah, so it's,
well, I want to say senior team, the men's equivalent,
men's team.
You can watch live in our league this afternoon. And so you can download it now. That kick is going to be short low from Jordan Overland. Yep, so it's a second unsuccessful conversion attempt of the afternoon. There's a scoreline remains here at 9-10 points for each. And the Raiders 38, two for Raiders 10. Another convincing victory there, then. Yeah, they're racking up these points now. It's 38, is it? 38-10 to the Raiders. And they're still 10 minutes to go, 14 minutes to go,
yeah,
what an hour did it take. There's a few more shots in it yet. Quite down there. She's going down that spot yesterday, really. She's desperate.
She's going to skip to the rest of the
year, isn't she? She's going to find that hole, and she's going to get that spot.
Yep.
She's going to hit that advantage one. Take all that advantage. Deep kick off then. From Keith and Charles by Laura Ackroyd. Puts it back. Puts it back really over because it's only out for me to take this up for myself here. So today he's going to start with Stanley on 10 minutes early. But in the real match, you know, Jody Crawford finds that space once more.
Really impressive idea is Jody.
Yeah. Barrow Island girl. Barrow Island girl. That's a game. Just get it in there. Yeah, together. Why not, Dan? Why not?
So good and near from Kelly Friend to still charging them next forward almost 10 metres gained on that one up towards the halfway line now as the ladies bring the ball back to our centre field. Number 17, Sarah Shields brought down. Ladies find themselves about 40 metres to go. Looking for their lead, turn of the afternoon, the ball comes out to the wind. So plenty up to the left hand side and Gelda's got some green here, so we're just waiting for the ball to aim the wind, sorry. So I think that's the ball now. It's down there. We spoke about earlier on. He took a little kick through. And he's a little bit too much weight on that one now. So it's going to go across.
It's supposed to be a start, isn't it? Just a little bit too much on the kick.
Yeah, it's a good idea. Just let me let it down a little bit. Just kicked it a bit too strong.
It's got one of the names here. I've just over 10 minutes to play. All ladies 38. Keithy ladies 10. Seven separate tries going to the afternoon for the ladies. But about a little still lacking, maybe a dragon, Matt Saunders, Sam Norman, Amy Sunderland, Jody Loveland, and Jody Crawford all on the side seat this afternoon. And I expect to be for Keithley, Laura Ackroyd, and Natalie Wilson. Sorry, Watson, sorry. But yeah, but it looks like it's in the second half, really. It has, yeah. I mean,
like you say, the Raiders, they've just managed to control the ball a little bit more. The stats probably, they're probably running at about 80%
85% maybe, you know, for completion, and that makes for time in your opponent's half, really. So, that's going to start off here for the FIFA ladies. I can wait to have a halfway line now. And she was able to get a first line of the afternoon. As things seem to have calmed down for me, things seem going on 10 minutes ago. But, slightly passing again. She's got some space now on the left-hand edge. It's really good. Going down. Down. It's Tifa and still on the attack here, so turns and puts to the off-line next after every time he was sitting. Flip over the top, taken down well, and the lucky there by it was Max Thorne as he was shouting it down and going on the top of the run. No skew out of read that, took it out of the air, but just couldn't control it on the way down. He's just going to stop for you, here he is. Looks like he's got a good injury. So, 2-3 forward, back play here. Just over 10 minutes or so to go now, just under 10 minutes in fact. That's all that means. Barrow, the ladies 38, Keith and ladies 10. Maybe 2 from 2 for the Barrow ladies. As they look towards this promotion to the Women's Super League. It's a cracking start indeed. And the ball's been knocked on. Kicked away for straight from that. Now, Keith will try and score it. Well, at that point, you know what, Dan, at least he's got. You know what, that's good. She was in a bit of strife earlier. I was just about to say that sums up her second half. But I look round, she's sitting up on his side. She's got a big beamy grin on her face. And she accepts she's made a whole lot of mistake. And it's good to see, it's good sportsmanship, really, isn't it? Shouldn't take yourself too seriously nowadays. So just need 10 minutes to go here of the second women's championship fixture of the season for the ladies. It's going to be 2-2, don't forget. 2 o'clock this afternoon, you can tune into our league. The coverage of the ladies against Keithley. Cougars, and the battle for top spots. I'm sure it'll be a fantastic game this afternoon. Listen to myself and Bruno on that stream as well. Your friend is now then for the ladies. Find yourself up towards the 40 metre mark, and there's some good meters there. Some good, a lot of good meters after this, isn't it? Very strong. Michelle Larkin is in, it's just not that one on. I think she's trying to play it on, she's good to see the two. So she's just standing on the winner's side on the left hand side, and she needs to try to get a quick ball out to him. He can't pay off, but I'm leading by 20 points, he's got a little bit of things like that. Yeah, I'm sure you won't be as bad now. If there's 10 points in it, we might be the same. Good tackle in there by Kenneth Aldaz. And the other lady, it's impressive this afternoon indeed. Just unfortunate she's not on that try sheet. This is good. The ladies have been penalised for that one, the ladies there. Now the Raiders now know they've got some defending to do, they've just given each other a few orders there, just saying don't get tired, let's stay strong, let's defend well. Let's remember they've got to play without the ball as well. And it's a few for Raiders that are going to restart this one, 35 metres away from the skyline. It's quite a try, but it's almost an hour in this match. Solid defence from the Barrow Raiders, since they conceded that second try early on in the first half. So, Mia Hussain. There's that ball 20 metres away from the sticks. Just dribbled that one there, which was brought out to the tackle. And the ball's come loose and once again collected by Barrow Raiders. Three ways to play on for this one. So it's an advantage by the ladies once more. Just found a good bit of space there as well. to the outside line, almost got free, but it was the trailing hands of Laura Ashroy that pulled down to the floor. Kerry Smith takes the ball, leads it towards the halfway line now. The ball just slipped out towards his left hand side, and everyone's trying to set something up here. And it's Peter Larkin who steps on. That's also another one, and she's through the gap here. She can get past the fullback. It's going to be another try. And she turns on the burners. It's a fantastic try for Claire Gale, that. I called it earlier. And she's finally got on the score sheet. What's a fantastic individual try there from the Raiders. Making it now a barrel. 4-2. 2-10. Yeah, well worked try there. Michelle Larkin stepped on the outside, looked like she was going to go around, then turned, looked on the inside, and there she was on the inside, the try scorer, and rounded the full back. I won't say Louise, but very good score, man. She's definitely taking the burners there with that 10 minutes to go. No sooner she got past that full back, and she got that try. This is the 8th try of the afternoon for my Raiders, and 8th in 50 full try scorers. Everybody else can see that in the hands already, is it going? Not at all. We've thrown the ball around well. And it just, like you say, it just goes the area where we've distributed the ball. I can't just stop my own fashion for 5 minutes to go. Successful conversion of 10 men from Joe Lovell, extending the lead here. As Ballerina's wants to go in the way with the match. So it's got like another big one, some prestige. It's Ballard Ladies 44, Keith Ladies 10. I'm sure the 2 weeks in the order, they love to hit that 50 marker. We've got 5 minutes left, so we can do it, Jim. So we can reach it. There's no doubt we can reach it. It's 1 try. There's how many minutes to go? 4 minutes to go. If we can control this ball, make a quick break, and finish it off nicely in style, a 50 would be good for the Raiders. She's definitely the boss, Jody, isn't she? I think the key turning point was the incident with about 20 to go, and it just set in stone the resolve that we've made is to really put this team to the sword, which is what we've in fact done. I'm sure knowing Saeedi was a very emotional, sort of enthusiastic guy. He'll be loving the way that we've controlled this game, especially the second half, and how his players have shown a lot of discipline to overcome this. It's been quite a tough Keithley team, really. So the ball has come to the touchline, that's a pick off, maybe the ladies switched off a little bit there. So it's the Keithley ladies that have got a massive advantage to find themselves. 5 minutes try, that try line, looking for the next third try the afternoon, that would be a consolation try at this point. But they'll do better than the rest of them. It's only 20 tries now in the last 3 games that this Raiders team have conceded. So we can take anything we can get, but already they're making it. And now they're there on the attack and they're going to lose the ball. So chance of that third try the afternoon is now gone. With a few minutes left on the clock, it's by the Raiders. They're going to get their chance to try and hit that 50 mark for 2 weeks in a row. Yeah, they'll get a lot from this game. Just listening to the players, just watching the players now, they're all patting each other on the back, they're all cocking each other up, saying how well they've done to stay strong and stay composed in such a, what they have. It's been a physical game. I suppose I'd use an analogy. I'd say it's a bit like two boxers. One likes to be inside, roughing up a little bit, and the other one likes to stay at arm's length and throw a bit of class and throw a few shots. And that's what the Raiders have done this afternoon. They haven't thrown a few shots, right? You know what I mean? So it's a few shots later.
Down there. Push track down.
Just trying to fight to hit the back as Luke Lundy is now. Just found a fantastic offload to Michelle Larkin. She's stepped the full back into the out. Michelle Larkin's going to go in for a brace this afternoon. She's a fantastic step from the good pass there on the left shoulder of Jodie Liverland. It's going to be 5-0 once again for the Lara ladies. After the conversion attempt from this going to be for the ladies 15. Keep from 10.
Very well received try that. She's very popular, isn't Michelle? She's been at the club a lot of years, hasn't she?
I definitely enjoyed that one there.
Oh, God, she's just had a little step, hasn't she? She called the phone back off, God, yeah. I think she's in the middle of 20s by now. She had a clean set of pair of heels there. I think it worked out as well, so nothing out of the race.
There goes the full-time whistle then. 9 tries today for Banner Ladies from 8 separate try scorers. Looking at full-time whistle. Banner Ladies 50, Keith Ladies 10. That's the one for Andrew.
Well, the second half, the Raiders needed to show a bit more composure just so they could take control of this game. They did that, they overcome the physical battle as the Keith Ladies got more frustrated, which turned into a little bit of rough and tough. So we weathered that storm and carried on playing rugby. And like you said, 9 tries, 8 scorers, a good way to win a game, throw the ball around.
A big thank you for tuning in this afternoon. See you back once again. As the Battle Ladies continue their surge for Women's Super League. Full time here by Johnson Prestige. The Battle Ladies 50, Keith McKinney's 10. We will see you shortly as we continue our coverage on the men's team against Keith McKinney's. That starts at 2 o'clock for a 3 o'clock kickoff. That is on the Arrow League app. You can buy that right now. All the links are online. Until then, thank you, Graham, once again.
Thank you. Well done to the Barrow Ladies.
And stay classy, Barrow.